What's up, people? It's Guru. Welcome to Geek Assault. Today's topic, Killing Bites, Episode 2. Let's go. Guys, actually like this episode a lot better than the last one. And we're getting more information about this one. It starts off with my man, Yuya, is about to get killed by this flasher chick. She has some kind of weird spikes coming out of her body. You pretty much figure it out real quick what she is, because like I said, all their abilities are animal based. So she turns out she's a porcupine and she can shoot spikes from all parts of her body. But the thing I didn't like about it was she had a weird accent. It was kind of crazy. I was like, eh. But she tried to make you gotta be a peeping Tom, so it seems bad right now. First he's a rapist, now he's a peeping Tom. So you know, my man Yuya can't win for losing, man. But she wants Hitame, and so she decides, well, if I kill Yuya, Hitame won't have anybody to use as an investor. Because like I said, she want to use his organs as a way to enter the tournament. Because it's four different groups, and pretty much she's like a rogue. She seems to be by herself because she isn't part of a group. But for some reason, everybody doesn't want, this chick doesn't want her to win, and she wants out of the tournament. I don't know if she's jealous and thinks she can't win, beat her, or what, but that was not the fact, because she attacks Hitame off the rip, and she's very powerful. She's a strong opponent. She seems more, how can I put it? I ain't gonna say she's a better fighter than Leo was last episode, but she seems, her technique was given Hitame a lot more trouble than Leo's did. Leo was more direct, straight up, attack you. He was just a power-based fighter, you know, just like a lion would be. But a porcupine, and this chick Spice, she could shoot him out or just like just cover her body and use it as a protective armor. So she has a very good technique. And she pretty much, it seemed like she had Hitame defeated, like she got stabbed up, but we find out that the hide or the pelt of the honey badger is too thick, so she can't actually get a, I guess, a critical blow onto Hitame. So it didn't even puncture her skin, and she was shocked by it because she said her quills even stronger than steel. And so for Hitame to survive all that and then use her special, I guess, her finishing ability that we think right now is called slash, and she cuts with her claws. And she pretty much fights over, man. It's like one hit or quitter, man. When she does that slash technique, they're done. She did the same thing to Leo. Yeah, he got hit with the slash, he was done. Actually, they actually killed Leo. But the porcupine chick actually survived it, but she's hurt pretty bad. And Hitame is a beast, man. She realistically, figuratively, real life, she's gonna finish her off. But Yuya was like, nah, don't do it to her, don't hurt her, even though she stabbed him through the leg and cut his nose with one of her spikes. He pretty much said, well, don't have mercy on her, don't kill her. And so, which is weird because, you know, they let the women survive, but the man, Leo just got killed, just got slaughtered. But I guess she didn't know that Leo's gonna die. And even though both characters did want him to die, Yuya to be dead, so it is what it is. But nothing to beat the meat of that. She has to go, she gets talked to her little, I don't know who that boss guy is. I can't think of his name. And I'm skipping ahead. We meet this other character. He's like I think he's a hippopotamus type character. He has this weird name. I'll just call him Ichi. But he wants Hitame to join his crew. And he said, you know, like they'll protect her. You know, she'll be on her crew because like right now she rogue. So I guess she really was rogue. Like, you know, I'm not blah. I'll do what I want to do. And so she refuses. But then she gets a call. And then when she gets the call, like I said, once again, whoever that guy is on the phone call, bam, you know, the attitude drops. She gets a smile on her face and she's very submissive. So she agrees to work for the crew, the hippopotamus crew, but not be a part of the crew, kind of. So I don't know how that's going to work out, but that's what she's vibing for. So, hey, we gonna roll with it. So then now she has to go to school with Yuya. So I think this is another weird thing. It's kind of weird, but I guess this leads somewhere. And she's kind of she's kind of distraught because the kids, the students don't pay attention to the teacher. He's an old man. He's very quiet. Like, you barely can hear him over the mic. And it's kind of like, she doesn't seem like the studious type. But for some reason, she's very intrigued by that and annoyed by it. Like, the kids weren't listening to him. And they show the scene, of course, like I said, this is an etchy. She's in the bathroom. She's sitting on the stall. And this little girl named stares at us, comes and starts talking to her. Find out, of course, she's a hybrid as well. I think her name's like Izuru or something like that. Izuru, I think her name is, something like that. And she's quick. And Hitame is actually in her hybrid animal form. And Izuru steals her panties from her. And, you know, they show the little scene, you know, because she has a tail when she transformed. So the back of her skirt ride up. So you see her little butt cheeks hanging out and stuff. So everybody's like shocked to see it and stuff. Like, oh my gosh, but so she's chasing after Izuru. And she can't keep up with her. And, like, mind you, she's in a hybrid animal form. And Izuru just outpacing her quickly. So we find out that Izuru, whatever her name is, she's actually a cheetah. That's her hybrid. And she's super fast. She's, like I said, she's way faster than Hitame. But Hitame's way more vicious because she had a point where she could defeat her, but she still was, like, shot, like, how Hitame was, like, backed into a corner, but she didn't give up. And she still went for, like, a, I ain't gonna say a killing blow, but she went for a deadly blow. Like, when you think, like, this could kill you, but you step into it, like, to counter it. So she was shocked by that. And she actually injured Izuru's hand by biting it. Kind of like she did Leo in the first episode when she bit off his fingers. But she only bit her on the hand, bit Izuru on the hand. I guess because she's so quick, she didn't get a chance to, like, get a real good bite like she wanted to on her. And so then these other hybrids pop up. We find one is a bear. And you barely even tell he's human. The only way you can tell he's human because he's standing on his hind legs and walk around. He had on pants. But you can't tell his facial features or anything. He's just covered up. He's like a big hybrid bear. You know what I'm saying? Just walking around. And it's another human. And he too big strikes at him. Like, goes at him like, yo, you know, let's bring the noise. You know, let's do this. You know, so she goes to him. And this guy, he's quick too. He invades her in human form and, like, just hanging from a tree. And then the bear, whatever that bear hybrid, knocks her back. She absorbs the blow and, like, ready to go toe-to-toe. But they stopped and said, look, we just hear the spirit of the word. We come in, blah, blah, blah. You know, Leo was part of their crew. So everything goes back to Leo, man. That first episode when she killed Leo, this guy must have been a big wig. I don't know what it was, but they're coming at her over Leo. And so she has more, like I said, we find out she has more enemies besides, she done beat Porcupine Girl, she done beat Leo, and they showed a quick picture of the crew, and it seemed like Leo was part of their crew. It seemed like he was almost like a front runner the way they had him standing. So I don't know how true it is if they, the way they stand on the picture was how strong each character was, or how it goes, what the hierarchy was, but he was on that picture. So some guy was out there looking at her with binoculars on, and he was like sweating because he, like I said, staring at the cheeks. He took his cheeks because, like I said, she doesn't have no panties on. She just has her skirt, whatever, school outfit skirt. Oh, another funny scene was that she bumped into Yuya without her panties on. She fell down and he got a glimpse, real good glimpse at her, nether regions. I mean, he was really in it, like, yo, face first in it, and she was like not paying no attention, man. And this one guy was just like, the guy that was a peeping Tom, he said, I can smell that female from here. But that was crazy. So I don't know, man, if she need to clean up a little bit or what's going on over there. But my man was intrigued by it. But I did a little research on the actual honey badger, and they said they do have some kind of I don't know what you want to call it, but it releases a smell. It's like a pheromone or something like that, and it's almost kind of like skunk like the Wolverine has one too, and I think the Wolverine is the, you know, they're related to the honey badger related to the Wolverine, whichever way it goes. But it says that the Wolverine, since I guess he's a little bigger than the actual honey badger, his scent is stronger. So they call him like a skunk bear or something. They call the actual Wolverine. And so I guess this honey badger's got some kind of, guess, gonna release some kind of pheromone or something. It's kind of got a smell to it. So I guess the character, whoever created this series, man, they did a little research on the honey badger Wolverines and what kind of, how they actually perform in the wild and stuff like that. So, went on a little tangent there. But, Joe, tell me what y'all thought about this episode, too, man. It was very entertaining. The etchiness, it was funny. And it was cool to be, man. I enjoyed it, man. Can't lie. I enjoyed it. So, tell me your thoughts in the comments section, man. If you haven't already, don't forget to rate and subscribe and all that good stuff. We got a whole bunch of new series coming to the channel. So I'm pretty sure there'll be something here for you. And yeah, this is Guru. Holla at you later. Peace.